Hi friends! Today I'm going to make some melted crayon art that I'm going to make Frozen themed. Very popular with my nieces. Let's see what happens. Alright, so the supplies that you're going to need for this is a blow dryer, hot glue gun. I like to add just a little bit of a matte coating to seal it. I'm going to add some glitter to it, black paint. I found these really cute glue sticks that are just different colors. I'm going to use the blue ones. Crayons, obviously. I found a whole bunch of different types of crayons. I've got some glitter ones in there, some metallic ones. I like to use a paintbrush. You'll see why. Some cute little snowflakes. And these are glitter. Those little fun little rhinestones. I've got a cutout of Elsa. Got a canvas here. I think it's 11 by 14. I'm not sure. Scissors and some contact paper. All right, so the first step that we're going to have is I'm going to put the silhouette of Elsa on top of the contact paper. I'm going to attach it to that, I'm going to tape it, and then I'm just going to cut that shape out to make my stencil. All right, so the next step is select which colors of crayons you like. Now I've chosen all different types. I've got some that, see these like purple wrappers? That's a special one. That's like, I think this one's sparkle. We've got some metallic ones in here. So I've just tried, it's like this one's glitter. Ooh, glitter. See that? How pretty. Okay, so now the next step is to get rid of all the wrappers. I've noticed it's kind of hard to get rid of these. So children, you will need adults for this. Because I've learned that the best way to do this is to get like a sharp edge and just attack it. See, look, there's a little bit. We're gonna rip them all off. Yes, this is a pretty lengthy process. Don't worry, I'm not going to film it all. All right, give me like 10 minutes and I will come back with them all ripped off. Alright guys, I'm back. So as you can see over here, I broke all the crayons in half. Oh, hi Toes. And I've also removed all of the paper. So I've tried applying my cutout to my canvas. Well, I wasn't very smart. Apparently, contact paper doesn't stick to canvas. I'm smart. So I just drew a quick little outline. I'm going to keep that on there, but I'm going to keep my cut out for later because I'm still going to figure out how to get the silhouette on there. I did see this idea on Pinterest. I didn't follow the rules. I'm just kind of looking at the picture and figured it out my way. So the next fun step is we're going to glue the crayons to the top of the screen. And right now I'm just waiting for my glue gun to heat up. Here's all the paper from all those crayons. I was testing it earlier. It looks so cute that it's blue instead of clear. So much fun. And I've got extras just in case I need more. So let's see. It's getting there. Okay. So, and I've already pre-picked out a pattern how I want to apply them all. So, I'm going to go ahead and apply all of them to my screen, to my canvas. All right, friends, as you can see, I've got a little outline of Elsa, just kind of how I want it all to look. I've got all of the crayons glued up at the top. And then what I like to do, because we're going to use a blow dryer at this point, this is the fun part. So I've covered a baking sheet with tin foil on it to catch all of the excess wax. As you see that paintbrush there, you'll see why I use it, because sometimes the crayons like to fall down and I kind of like to guide them a little bit so I get the look that I want. So now we're going to do the fun part. And yes, this is being shot in my bathroom because, in the words of the genie, I have itty bitty living space. I live in a really small apartment, so I have to do with what I have. All right, guys, let's go have some fun and melt these crayons. Let's see what happens.
The snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of isolation, and it looks like I'm the queen. The wind is howling like this swirling storm inside. Couldn't keep it in, heaven knows I tried. Don't let them in, don't let them see. Be the good girl you always have to be. Conceal, don't feel, don't let them know.
My friends, now that we saw that cool video, didn't mean to end you rocking out to Let It Go, but we do have to change pace here. But I don't know if you can see it, so I went back with a pencil and kind of just carved out the image from the stencil that we had on there earlier. I don't know if you can see how cool this looks. There's some glitter that is dripped down from those glitter crayons. There is glitter in the white. It's kind of hard to see in this lighting, but it is there. I just think this looks really, really cool. I like to go more flat. I've seen other melted crayon art that they'll keep like the paper on there. There's a whole bunch of different styles that you can do. This is just what I like in particular. I like the ending product. And I just like how all the different colors blend together. You can do whatever you want. Just so you know, when I was using my blow dryer, I was using it on low but high heat. So a low speed but a high heat. Otherwise you get all these splashes everywhere. We don't really want that. Well, at least that wasn't the look I was going for. So here's that finished product. And as I'm sure you saw, I used the tip of the paintbrush to kind of pull things down. Because sometimes you get like these little bubbles or these little pockets. Like we've still got another one here, but I'll paint that black. And sometimes they just need a little extra coaxing to get out of there. It is fully dry right now, by the way. And that's when I'll use that, the ending tip of the paintbrush. As you can see, you can still see the glue up at the top. That's why I chose that blue glue. I personally like how this looks. It's all up to your artwork, though. You do what you want. I personally like how this looks, though. All right, so the next step is we are going to paint in Elsa. That's the next step. All right, my friends, here is the finished product. As you can see, I've added some fun snowflakes and some glitter spray. I've painted Elsa on there. I would have taped myself actually painting her on there, but I had to get really up close and my camera would have gotten in the way. But as you can see, I've tried to paint the sparkles kind of in a swirl, like how our arms are going, so you can see all that. So that is the finished product. I like it. Just let me know if you like it. Well, thanks for taking this journey with me, friends. This was the first video I've ever posted on YouTube. Please leave comments below. Let me know how I did. Let me know if there's anything you want to see. Please subscribe to my channel. I am going to upload things every single week. It will always be Disney themed. My name is Disney Craft Girl. My real name's Liz, but I'm going to go by Disney Craft Girl. You can follow me on Instagram and Twitter, Disney Craft Girl. Please subscribe to my channel. If you have any ideas that you want to try, that you want to see me try, I don't really follow the directions or read the blogs on Pinterest. I just kind of look at the picture and do what I want to do, and we just kind of take this journey together. Again, thanks so much for taking the time to watch this video. Please subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Have a great, big, beautiful tomorrow. Bye, friends.